opportunity. Now Chara fakes the shot. Tyler Seguin to Hamilton. Back to Seguin. Oh, what a stopping rebound. It's Gaur! After another great save. The Bruins put it home.
Tyler Seguin finally gets one, Dave, and he got it on the second chance. He had to stay with it. Some brilliant goaltending from Henrik Lundqvist. I don't know how he made some of those saves, and even right before Seguin scores, watch Lundqvist has to find the puck on the initial rush here and the play across there. Look at that, and then there's the rebound by Seguin. Seguin stays with it, he stays calm. Moves in from the point like he has. The right-hand shot at the top of the umbrella, and that's how he attacks. They set him up for his ability to move in with the puck. A nice give and go. Dougie Hamilton giving it back to him through that open area in the middle of the ice, but very calm under pressure, especially for a guy like Seguin who has been pressing to score a goal.
First goal of these playoffs for Tyler Seguin, but it hasn't been for a lack of putting pucks at the net. He came in leading the Boston Bruins in shots on goal throughout the playoffs, fourth in the league. Not a power play goal, though. The penalty had expired. I don't know that McDonough ever got back, though, to be a factor in the play. By the time Seguin got his own rebound and put it past Henrik Lundqvist. 3-2 Bruins. And again, we've talked about this before, Brian. This is a team of players that many of them have won a cup. Boy, that could be too many men on the ice. Are they going to call this? Yes, they are. Right? We could see it very plainly from up here. And Nash and Chara are still playing. I don't think they realize there's been a whistle. I didn't think the official saw it at first, but right in front of our broadcast position here, clearly there were six Bruins on the ice when it was played. Kelly is trying to argue his case.
Yeah, they're arguing. The Bruins are arguing, but the linesman actually made the call. It was Scott Cherry. Scott Cherry, the linesman, saying, no, no, your guy was not nearly close enough to the...